Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the cognac show. Limousines drinking the finest champagne. Wearing furs, dazzling diamond jewelry. A girl can't complain. I live the upscale life, dining in the finest restaurants. Eating the best caviar for free. And no matter how much I enjoy myself, they can't.
Start spreading the news. You're leaving today. Tell them, Frank.
I want to be a part of it. New York.
Welcome back to Cognac's Corner. I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at 845 United Nations Plaza in the World Trump Bar. And I'm here with the most charming couple in all of Manhattan, Simon Van Kempen and Alex McCord, the reality TV stars of the Real Housewives of New York City. So you guys have been incredible.
Last week, Dallas over the weekend. We're off to Miami on Thursday.
That's right. We are on our book tour for our book that was released last week, Little Kids, Big City.
Yes, I was there.
No, thank you so much for coming. We have been doing signings and readings pretty much every night. And
what does that feel like? It's like your first book. Isn't it your first book?
It is our first book, and we wrote it together. And when we do the readings, we actually, since our book is a he said, she said, we actually switch off reading. And it's been fun. It was really great to be in Texas over the weekend because all of my family is from there. And we got such great feedback from people like my mother and whatnot because they had never seen the show side of us together. And they love listening to us play off each other and answer questions about the show. It's funny. You know, we do that every day in New York and LA and for the media and for the press and whatnot. It was really poignant to actually share it with people who aren't used to reality us.
And look, the great thing that we found is that, you know, I've had to come back to New York because we have day jobs as well. I mean, you know, we are real people with real jobs. So we've flown back.
Yes, I know, darling. I called you at the Chandler Hotel.
You phoned me at work yesterday, didn't you? And I had to answer my own phone.
And he answered his own phone. I got the shock of my life. I couldn't believe it. I thought your secretary was going to answer the phone.
I like to say that we put the real in Real Housewives.
Exactly.
So, you know, it's been so great meeting our fans as well. Because, you know, we had 50 in Orange County. We were on alien territory. That's where the first Housewives was, Orange County. We had a great turnout at Borders last week in Costa Mesa. And to meet these men and women, and there are a lot of men too, not all gay, but most of them. And, you know, to get to talk to us, how they've watched us over the 3 years, and they know that we haven't changed, just they've got to see a broader opinion and sort of more of us.
And you know, one thing that's interesting is as we go across the country, it's amazing to see the power of the internet, because there are so many people that would come up to us at signings and say, I'm so-and-so, that's my handle on BravoTV.com, or that's my handle on Facebook or Twitter.
Hi, Housewives Junkie in Dallas.
Cool thing, but it's also a case of, when do you switch off?
I mean, you know, as you rang me at work yesterday, I have a day job. When I'm at work, I don't do Facebook or Twitter for the TV show, so I do it after hours. So, you know, we go home in the evening, we're with the boys until they go to bed at 8 o'clock, 8:30.
Uh-huh.
And then it's, what did we do last night? We sat at our computers from 8:30 till midnight 30. Facebook, Twittering, whatever.
You know, I was just talking to somebody, a scientist, before you sat down, and he said that the world has changed. It's so stressful. We have, not only do we work the hours of daytime that we have to work, but now we have to promote ourselves even more than ever.
But you know what? I'm going to go with the flip side of that. The way our world works right now, those of us who are rabidly type A are actually more mellow because we have so much to chew on. We have a lot to keep us busy, and I love being busy. When I'm not busy, that's when you see my head start to spin and turn green.
How many states have you been to so far within the United States promoting the book?
Only five so far. 10%. We've still got another 45%, 90% to go.
The girls on the Housewives show in New York.
Aren't they awful? I'm telling you.
She's got that southern charm.
Actually, I wouldn't say. I
not
like
all of them.
See, I like the Countess. I like her. I like her.
If she dropped her shtick, and we said this in an interview over the weekend, when the Countess isn't being the Countess, she's really lovely. But when she's putting on all the airs and graces,
yes,
that's when you get, she slips on the burner and like, bang.
Well,
she's a lot of fun.
The few times that I've spoken to her and I've interviewed her in the Hamptons,
yes,
and at also at Milan Bertin's fashion show,
yes,
she was wonderful.
She was that day, absolutely.
She was really wonderful.
You know, the thing that's been interesting for me doing this show for 3 years, and I love the fact that we've got all the original cast from the first season, because as you go on, you develop a relationship and everyone's true colors come out.
Yes.
And that's why you've seen so many crazy alliance shifts this season, because we figured out who we really like the best. And you know what's funny? We're now at a point that there are some women in the cast that I speak to almost every day.
Which, really?
Yes. And then there are some that...
About 4 times a day?
No, never 4 times a day. I don't even speak to you 4 times a day.
Well, not politely anyway.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I'm hearing so much controversy over Jill Sarah and what she said about Brooklyn Fashion Week. What do you...
I wonder about that. That night, you hear her say a few things that are rude, but most of the rude things she said a month or two later when she's doing the Talking Head interviews, which are filmed sometimes weeks and months afterwards. And I
She keeps telling everybody, stop blaming me for something that happened 6 months ago.
She said these words. I mean, you know, unless the producers were feeding her words, and if they are, more fool her for saying them.
Exactly.
You know, we are all responsible for what comes out of our mouth. We were season one, our problem season one, is that you only saw this much of us. And without the context, and you know, that we are a loving, normal couple, you just saw the high societies, you know, social climates, whatever. And so you got this very one-dimensional view of who we were. Now over the 3 years, you've seen everything about
it. I think that's the key. In the first season, you saw one dimension of everyone, positive or negative. And now you've seen so much more of everyone that you get a clearer picture for whom everyone is.
Except Ramona, who's been the crazy one all the way through.
Well, she's bipolar.
She's been consistent.
Aw, we love Ramona.
We love her anyway. But you know something, darlings? I tell everyone this. The Real Housewives of New York is really a soap opera without the script.
And yes, without the budget.
Without the budget.
Yeah.
But I tell everyone, you want to see drama? You want to see sex? You got to watch The Real Housewives of New York, because it's just really a soap opera. It's a 21st century version of soap opera.
Well, and that's why our show has now been sold into syndication.
Right.
Not just New York, but New York, Atlanta, New Jersey, and the original, the OC. Because it's replacing soaps.
Right.
I mean, soaps have always sort of, both daytime and nighttime, going to Dynasty and Dallas and so on. They were so, you know, these days, real life is more crazy. Some of the stuff that we've seen on our show.
Well, you should see things that go on in my life.
I can only imagine.
Enough said about me. I want you guys to tell my audience where your next appearance is going to be. You're going to be in Miami. Tell my audience.
We will be...
Aventura Boulevard, North Miami, Thursday at 7 p.m. That's Thursday, April 22nd.
And the following day, Friday, we'll be in Boca Raton.
At 7 p.m.
And then we will be in Fort Lauderdale on Saturday.
At 4 p.m.
And Tampa on Sunday.
At 2 p.m.
And if you didn't get all that, just go over to McCordVanKempen.com, and that has all of our signings in order, and you can keep tabs on where we'll be next.
And as you mentioned in our interview at Borders, Australia might be next, and Canada.
In fact, it was funny, my mom emailed me this morning, late last night, wasn't it, that on page 11 of today's Sydney Morning Herald, there's this whole write-up about, what do they call them? Misery memoirs. So it's a play on words. They're memoirs, but memoirs. And there's all these books have been written by Australian journalists of how they've had children and hated it.
Right.
And my mother, who's read our book, was saying, well, look, yours is such an upbeat, you know, it's a great thing. Yes, kids can be frustrating, but above all, so rewarding. We should get our book out there. And I said, wait until the third season of our show starts in New York, which should be around August, September of 2010.
Yep.
And then that'll give us an excuse to go back home to Australia.
Exactly. So we can go and promote it and see the family. There's always an agenda.
Do you think you might branch out and possibly do another reality show about your you yourselves and your children?
You know what? It's early days. At the moment, we're really having fun on Housewives. I think that Bravo's starting to put their toe in the water with Bethany's show. And, you know, we all hope that she gets great ratings for that. We all have very high hopes for her and for Bravo for that. So, who knows?
In my mind, there's something to be said from us.
Tell my audience one more time the website.
McCordVanKempen.com.
And I'm sure you can link to it from cognacwellerlane.tv.
Absolutely, darling. Let's toast.
To cognac.
Yes, to cognac. And the Van Kempens. We'll be back in a moment, darlings, and more celebrity interviews. Keep watching Pink Champagne Kisses.
Fantasy dress to impress. One of a kind girl.
This has been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.